Hello and welcome to this virtual tour of the Pats building, which is the home of the Department of Music and Media here at the University of Surrey. Now, as you can see, one of our colleagues has got carried away in Minecraft and done an entire virtual build of the Pats building. So I'm going to give you a tour round. I'm tempted to do it in the slightly over-the-top way of all the Minecraft videos my children seem to watch all the time, but I'll try and keep it calm as much as possible as we go around. So we started by looking in the stores, and this is where a lot of our cameras and our microphones are held, which are bookable out by students, so they can book out the kind of wide range of things that we've got for their projects. Here we're going through the edit rooms, so we have 5 edit rooms available for students, and these are used for, well, all sorts of editing. That might be audio editing using Pro Tools or Logic or Pyramix, or it might be video editing or music composing. There's all sorts of things that can happen in these edit rooms. And so into one of our storerooms. If you are studying music performance as part of one of our music courses and you have a large instrument like a harp or a double bass, then there's space here for you to store your instrument so you don't have to carry it around with you all day. I think I can hear a session going on in Studio 3, so let's look in.
Every now and then I try to disappear, bolt myself into a room and live a lie.
So this is Studio 3. It's designed for Tonmeister students to mix things that have been recorded elsewhere, but there is a small voice booth and overdub booth there which we can use for recording. But as you can see in that video, some students like to rig the musicians in the middle of the room and record it straight there. Quickly on into Studio 1. This is our big performance and classical recording space. So Studio 1 is used for the Wednesday lunchtime concerts and a few other performances. It's also used for some of our large ensemble rehearsals like the orchestra and choir, but the rest of the time it's bookable by Tonmeisters to make recordings. It's designed mainly for classical recording, but students record all sorts of things in here, whether that's pop or jazz or classical. Something that's common across all of our programmes is that the equipment and facilities provider are of the highest standard, whether that's musical instruments, video cameras or recording consoles. Now into Studio 2, our pop recording studio. So Studio 2 is designed for pop recording as opposed to Studio 1, which is used for classical recording. But again, students record all sorts of weird and wonderful things in the studios. And now we're off to the control room for Studio 1, our big recording space. And as you can hear, that's a jazz session that was happening in there. So we have many practice rooms that are used for instrumental lessons and for personal practice. We're looking through each of them as we go along. We see most of them have pianos in. There's one that's designed for percussion practice, so has percussion instruments that you can book out to put in there. During the week, these practice rooms are humming with rehearsals of all styles of music. And that's really a great thing about our department, that we cover such a wide range of musical genres, and each of these genres is held equal. And during the course, pretty much any style of genre that you're into, there'll be something in the course that you can apply your skills, that you can develop your knowledge and understanding through the courses that you take. We couldn't create the drum kit and amps in that room in Minecraft. So the project room or synth lab is a room that's absolutely full of Moog and other synthesizer equipment. So you can go in there, and it's mainly used by creative music technology students, but you can make all sorts of weird and wonderful noises and creative uses of sound, as you can hear from that example which came from rehearsal of one of our electronic music concerts. So we've gone through the workshop where the magical imps look after the equipment and make sure everything works perfectly, and now we're on to the offices. This is the office of the department administrators, and they look after all sorts of things, whether that's arranging performances for the department or helping you with any problems you have with your courses. Here's another staff office. Oh, I'm not sure about the artwork they had there. Maybe that's the office of a member of staff who studies metal or something like that. The department is a really great community, and you often find students hanging around in the upstairs foyer here, whether that's just socialising or doing group work or helping each other and learning from each other as part of the courses. We have two more edit rooms up here. So edit 4 has a voice booth for doing various recording and editing work. And the other edit room again has lots of software for video and audio editing and composition and all sorts of great things like that. So that brings us to the end of our whistle-stop tour of the Pats building. It's a real shame that you weren't able to come and join us on an open day. We hope that you will be able to come along for future open days, but I hope it gives you a really good idea of the kind of things that happen in our department. It's a really lively environment. There's lots of things going on all the time, and it's a really great community of students and staff. Please use some of the links that are shown here and will be in the YouTube description below to listen to some more of our student work. And please use this link to find out much more about us and the courses we run and all the brilliant things you can do if you come here. Thank you very much.